guess who it is. This is Salamancer. You're watching, probably watching SalTV, I don't even know. But this is going to be a pretty awesome game here between the Syndicate and Proprietary 9, shortened to Prawn, which is pretty hilarious. I am joined today by Star.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? We are watching a match here on Viaduct. Teams had a choice to play either Pro or regular Viaduct. We got Pro going on right here. Big difference is the shortcut on the left-hand side, depending on what team you're looking at, you know what I'm talking about. And my personal opinion, this is a lot harder to play for 9v9. There is nowhere safe for a medic to stand when you have this going on.
No, especially when there's a crit streak, and both teams are using the crits right now. Looks like Pig O' Death, the red demo man, has gotten a lot of kills off of that, but I don't know, it seems like Blue is still managing to cap the point somehow.
Yeah, Blue team's still getting it pretty good there. Everyone is dying. It looks like Red team's probably even going to recover it just after they're done. No, Heavy goes down too heavy, and they just get pushed right back, and then backstab's going on, pretty chaotic, and that is Pro Viaduct. Oh. People come from every direction, it seems.
Yeah, Flak was doing the pyro for Blue team, doing a really good job there. He ended up getting not a reflect kill, but he got a lot of reflect damage on a soldier and then finished him off with the shotgun. Took down Stabby too, which is no mean feat in itself. Stabby, I know you're watching.
Big thing about this map is that the team that is holding the point that currently has it has a longer respawn time than the team that's attacking. So every person that you lose is a big deal, and you need to be able to push on those advantages.
That's very true, Star. And it looks like our Blue team is starting to lose a couple players. They've lost their spy. Their scout was a little far forward and took a lot of damage, but he is going to be okay for a little while. But, oh, the sniper goes down. And killing the enemy sniper is a pretty big deal on Viaduct.
Yeah, definitely. Also got many sentries going up. I like the placement of the red dispenser sort of in the house there, so you know it won't be getting destroyed anytime soon. Usually it gets placed up quite a bit further and always, always gets blown up. Red team's moving in pretty strong right now. Got the heals, got everything going on for them right now. Able to capture the point and push them back.
Yeah, it looks like Haku is watching out for that spy right now, but Jackal, still alive, has managed to get away for a while. Red team did cap the point, but they've got about a minute left before they're even caught up with the time of their opponents. And they still can't find that spy. There he is! Jackal finally goes down.
Can never find those spies. JJK is up here looking for someone to snipe on the midpoint. Not able to see anyone quite yet. Heavy is in fact doing work, and I actually didn't even notice, but the blue medic did go down. Red one almost has uber or crits. I forgot what he was using. I feel terrible right now. That is in fact a crit streak.
Yeah,
it is ready.
Crits.
Yeah, crits is very, it's very critical on this map. Ha!
Oh, it really is though. It seems like teams that use the crits, especially in Platinum where both teams are playing pretty well, they're just going to have the crits that much faster because it charges faster than a regular Uber, and pretty much they'll be ready to be aggressive whenever they need to take that point back. Right now, Pig O' Death getting a kill without the crits, hasn't even had to pop it yet, but Malent is going to get the crits up soon, and if Red Team doesn't pop that pretty soon, they could be in for a surprise.
Oh, Blue Team actually popped theirs before Red even did. They had time to get it, but Red Team cleans them out with the Demoman using crits. Very powerful. Whoa. On this map. Demoman in general, you need to keep him alive on this map because it is so easy to spam over this little tiny, tiny hill that you got in the middle. Just enough for him to hide behind.
Yeah, it's a useful thing. Of course, they've got their sniper pretty far forward right now. They've got their medic hanging out in this nice spot right next to the hand. Right next to actually the Pug Loaf inside. As you guys may or may not know, there is a Pug Loaf on the pro version of this map. Or is it called Dog Bread?
Oh, what that is.
Dog Bread. Okay, no, so you know the metal door with the hand on it?
Just
zoom through that. There's totally Dog Bread.
I will
in
find
there.
This in 20 minutes and tell you guys it's awesome.
Anyway, no, it's actually a pretty good spot to be hanging out for a little while. As long as your opponents don't push to the point where the sniper can see you, you've got a lot of room so that if the opponents bring in like a jumping soldier or demo man or whatever, you can see him coming in, you can dodge really accurately, so it's a good spot to be hanging out, but it looks like our red team has been pushed back just a little bit.
Red team's actually looking really good right now. They have the crit streak ready. Blue has nowhere close to having it. And they're just, you know, sitting pretty behind that big old rock right there, healing up the demo man, just waiting for people to kill.
Stabby going huge, too, and he's managed to dodge his opponents for now. Skype Messiah is looking for some kills here, but let's see. Stabby still alive. One health left on this guy. He's managed to get behind his opponents. No, he's not behind his opponents right now. I'm sorry. He had to retreat.
So yeah, still not had to pop that crit screen. They're being really conservative with it, and Blue Prawn has not been able to actually push up, but it looks like they're going to get their opportunity right now. They're being very aggressive because they need to be. If they don't, they are going to lose this round with just 15 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah, thing is, Pigo Death could have that crit. Oh, no, he can't. I'm sorry. Jordy died there, so somehow this could actually be the opportunity they need. Stabby's going to be walking around grabbing some ammo.
Chris Creed popped on the blue Demo Man, too. He's not able to get any real kills. He got one with it, looking for some more.
Well, Stabby ended up taking him down there with that wonderful little Spicicle.
Yeah, Spy does a lot of work on this map, too. There is a lot of high ground where you can't just spy check in front of you and around you. You need to look up in the sky for when they're about to jump on top of you.
Yeah, right now, Red Team is going to have those faster respawns, and they've got a minute and 20 left before they lose the round. So at any point, since it's in overtime, if they recapture that point, then it's over, and the Syndicate will have won round one.
Yes, that actually puts them in a really good situation, because you know as soon as you cap it that you don't need to worry about contesting it or defending it. You just win immediately.
But Jordy gets shot by Skype the Saya, and so
in the body.
Yeah, there is a crit screen going down. That medic gets taken down real fast. But is it going to be a too little too late? I think Blue Team's going to defend this for a little while here, and so Proprietary 9 may end up winning the round if Blue Team can't put together another push, or Red Team, I'm sorry, can't put together another push real fast.
Well, they do in fact have time to respawn, and as I was saying before, they're going to respawn before the Blue Team does because they're holding the point. They've got one last chance here to get in here as quickly as possible and make it happen.
Well, we'll see where they can do it. Sky Messiah gets taken down by JJK. Not JFK, my friends, but JJK. And so Maylet here is going to try and charge Gritskrieg. It might be a little bit too late for that to actually happen. Only 15 seconds left in the round, and he's not healing anybody right now. His heavy is at 37 health, which is
96% medic isn't healing anyone at the moment and goes down.
Oh, no.
Really unfortunate there.
Yeah, the Syndicate. Oh, they've got a scout on the point and a sniper
it's
coming
okay.
in.
Okay. They have a mini sentry.
Yeah, that mini sentry.
Nothing defeats the mini sentry.
Not at all. And the engineer dancing because that mini sentry just won them the round. He's liking it. So
good
that
round
is,
indeed. That was very close at the end.
Round one goes to Team Prawn, Proprietary 9.
I don't know how they get Prawn out of that, but...
Well, 9 starts with an N. If you read it as a word.
Okay. I'll agree with that.
It works! Maybe that's just the alcohol logic talking, but... it sounds like it works to me. The Syndicate backed up a little bit beneath these choke points, which means they are not going to be contesting this point very quickly. It looks like Blue Team has a much better position.
Jackal pooped on their scout. He is dead. There's a blue spy is behind them right now. They're going to be pretty vulnerable to that as well. The Critskrieg is coming in from the Blue Team.
Wow.
Clean them up. A lot of work being done right here, and they are sitting pretty on the point.
That was some really amazing play, actually. The Critskrieg seemed like it took most of the attention off of the Red Team. And then Jordy actually didn't die to the crits. He died to KTB, I want to say, the soldier jumping into the other side. So really impressive to see the Blue Team just cut them off at every angle and captured the point. They didn't get their advantage. Never mind, I thought they were going to have an advantage, but it turns out Jordy really respawned fast.
Yep, I'm having a hard time telling who is who. My HUD actually is a little bit messed up, so when someone does something awesome, you give them the props, and I'll say, that was this class.
Stabby died. I'm sorry, I'm terrible at camera work.
Crits immediately popped right now by the blue as soon as they got it, heading over here to the left side, or once again, whatever perspective, you are countered by the crits. There are so many teams in Platinum that just solely 100% want to run crits all the time. They don't care what map it is, we're running crits. And it seems like that's what both teams are doing at the moment.
Good work being done by Haku the Pyro right now. Red Pyro took down that soldier with a nice flare shot and then helped find the spy and dig him out as well. So Jackal is down, and that's going to be the Syndicate capturing the point. But once again, they're in a situation where they need to catch up about a minute and 30 seconds.
Yeah, not looking too good for them right now, but definitely they can come back from it. There's plenty of time to make a push happen at this point. Red Team, it's going to be hard to sit on that the whole time, but it's definitely doable.
Yeah, in Highlander, I was going to say, as far as a crit screen goes, you just need to put out a lot of damage. And my old Highlander team actually played in a 6v9 once, and the Sixes team pretty much said, okay, we can't beat you guys unless we use crits because we have to do a bunch of damage. JJK looks like he might have disconnected or lagged out or something here, Not gonna be good for him. Okay, he did manage to survive that somehow.
We are about to see that crit showdown right now. Love seeing it, where both teams just run at each other. Here comes the heavy with the glowing minigun to counter that, and then everyone dies. Nobody gets a winner in a first crit battle.
Wow, this is actually, the cleanup is just as amazing as the crits was. The crits actually didn't do all that much, but look at that cleanup by the Syndicate completely ruining everybody on blue team.
Kron, pretty much the only person who survived was the spy, because I'm sure he was hiding from that mayhem, and the engineer must have been off building somewhere else.
Yes, that's going to be Kron losing the point, and actually Jackal ended up dying, going in for a stab afterwards there. That's Stabby now dying as well. So the spies are not having an especially good time, and it's kind of a small map, so easy to get caught out and destroyed by an entire 9-man enemy team.
Yeah, Dead Ringer is definitely very popular on this map. It's generally hard to not Dead Ringer on here, because there are just explosions everywhere. In the beginning of the match, it's kind of hard not to get hit by something. And we already have both teams once again having crits at the same time, because they both, well, once again, both medics just sort of traded for each other.
Which seems to be happening more and more. The cleanup, once again, is looking pretty good for the red team, but they've lost the point, and Cougar still has that mini sentry just right there. Gonna stop the scout from well, I thought he was gonna stop it from coming in, but it turns out the scout just said, nope, I'm gonna kill everyone. In fact, that was actually the engineer, Sexy Shane, coming in and doing some sexy kills of his own.
Stabby on point right now. I just noticed he is, in fact, using the Spicicle, so Stabby, I hate you. I am so sick of that weapon in Highlander. But, you know, you got to deal with it.
Why is it that you're sick of it? So you play Pyro, don't you?
I play Pyro. So I am the only person who ever realizes when a spy is actually using it, and when my team says, hey, you didn't spy check, he got to my sentry. What do you expect me to do? He's got the Spicicle.
Yeah, it kind of sucks. It looks like he is getting in position to maybe take out that medic over there. Maybe. But he just might get spotted. Oh! Wow, perfect timing on that decloak. Going for the headshot now on the medic instead of going for the stab, because he does see that spy, or the pyro, I mean, over there.
Crit streak was popped, but he immediately did die to something. Something is covering my kill feed, so I don't know what.
Oh, he stabbed the enemy spy, got killed by a rocket jump. I don't even think, I don't think Bravo knew what happened there. And JJK now. Looking for some headshots on that. Maybe the soldier, maybe the heavy, who knows? But this is getting to be a pretty close round here. 30 seconds, 40 seconds left for each team, and I think the Syndicate is going to grab this point right back.
Yeah, very Syndicate has a very big force on the point right now. They are Jirati, but they definitely have the numbers to hold this off. Mini Sentry down, completely ready for any pushes, and a lot of Kron is dead in the process. Their medic not up either. Syndicate has the Kritzkrieg ready. So I think they're going to be able to hold this off and actually take this match right here, unless something ridiculous happens.
Yeah, this round will go in the way of the Syndicate, and that is probably going to be 1-1, just as soon as the fat lady quits counting down.
There it goes, Kritzkrieg pop, because why not? The Critical Krieg, as I hope more people start to call it. I don't know why. I love that.
You're not a fan of World War II references?
No. Well, I am, but Critical Krieg sounds much more professional.
Okay, well, it doesn't sound as German, I'll tell you that much.
Yes.
Demo Man getting out here, and both of them got to the point about at the same time, just trying to deal damage to each other. Very important for them to get out and do some early spam, trying to hit their opposing medics with rollers and everything else.
Syndicate definitely not winning out on this. They lost their heavy pretty early, their medic down as well, but it's okay because I'm sure they probably tried to suicide Kron, get their medic so that they're even on those Kritzkriegs, and that is exactly what happened. Kron is going to be able to take this midpoint.
Yeah, they are, and I think that's all three rounds in a row that they've done that, so the problem they have seems to be more with holding it than just taking it.
Yes. I also want to call out that this map, I've said a couple things, like Demoman's important, Spy's important. I think this is a map where really every class is needed, where the Sniper is really, you know, crucial, the Pyro to push things back. There really isn't a class that is sitting around waiting for something to happen on Viaduct.
No, and actually, you'll find that on payload maps, especially, sometimes Scout isn't all that useful. But Scout is super useful for these maps. He can get in behind the opponents real fast and just cause havoc if he can aim well at all.
Yes, having a Scout or Soldier to hunt down the Sniper is important. You need to have someone up on that cliff or defending yours. Everyone has something to do here. It is Highlander. We have the Demoman rolling in with those Critical Kriegs. throwing those stickies down everywhere. The blue medic, he just bailed. He's not healing anyone at the moment. Wants to make sure he doesn't lose that. He's at 88%, so gonna want to make sure he keeps that so they can repush once this chaos is over. Syndicate right now is very blobbing up on point. There they go. We've got a soldier up now on the cliff, spreading out their forces a little bit to defend. And Zeke's spy play coming in gets taken down, though. That was pretty nice to see.
Yeah, Jackal got in trouble there. He got popped in the air and didn't really want to be flying as much as I know we all want to fly every now and then. That was not the right time for it.
Definitely not. Kurtzkrieg, once again, almost ready. It feels like they are always ready. At this point, I should probably just stop saying it. You should assume that someone has crits.
Pretty much. Sugar J here looks like he may want to take the crits, but he just probably won't be in position to... Oh, yes, he will! Takes down Tapes, takes down two more players who were standing on top of each other. That was an Engineer and Pyro, maybe. And is he done yet? He kills Flak, too. So, wow, Sugar J completely demolishing there with that crits.
Yes, also it didn't push up to try and chase them. They did need to capture the point, but there really wasn't anyone left alive that he really needed to chase down. Prawn is going to have the uber advantage at this point. They're going to come in strong with that for sure, and they're going to have the respawn advantage as well. I have a feeling they probably are going to be able to retake this.
They just might. Stabby is going to go look for anything that he can do. Maybe
dispenser pick.
Goes to that dispenser pick. He will probably take down that mini sentry at least, and that's just going to cause the engineer to have to rebuild it. A couple seconds where the mini sentry may not be shooting anybody. But, oh, Pick of Death defends himself, but then dies to a crit pill from Tapes.
It is okay. The spy from Prawn also got a dispenser pick, so teams are even now. Blue team recapturing the point. Looking pretty strong now. As I predicted, I'm just a genius. Ooh, Stabby is behind the medic right now, able to get the stab on him. Pyro turns around to get him. Spy School at this point trying to revolver him down, but no, he left a nice statue of the medic there. He did his job.
So that was actually, were you looking at the blue spy there? Because that was Jackal. Stabby is, of course, the red spy.
I cannot see player names. I apologize. Okay.
Yeah, but that was a really good stab there by Jackal on that medic. So it's going to give Malent, the blue medic, a huge crits advantage. He's got it ready now. Pop that whenever they need to. And so this round, I mean, just based on that, well, I was going to say the longer they held it, the more chance they would have, but even so, they just might win this round.
Yeah, I kind of disagree with how aggressive they were with it. He did put out a couple of stickies, but the Heavy is taking them out now. It probably would have been a better move to back up, just say, you know, we won this, they're retreating, we can stand on the point and let them push into us.
Yeah, of course, if they had done that, they ran the risk of waiting for Jordy to build up to a crit, so I can see why they might choose to push.
It's going to happen either way, and the way they played it now, Jordy's going to have the crits before them, so everyone always has crits.
True. Very true. Tapes, of course, has a sticky trap on that little log right next to the point. It's a nice spot to have it. Not immediately visible to everybody who walks onto the point.
Syndicate is building up for a push. They sort of waited and spawned until everyone was respawned. They've got their Heavy and Soldier pushing in strong here, and they have a regular Uber. Nobody has crits right now.
Oh my!
I have no idea what just happened.
Well, it seems to have caught their opponents by surprise. Normally, we think of the crits as a surprise play, but this time around, it's a surprise Uber, everybody. It turns out they're invincible.
Wee-woo. I'm actually really happy somebody used Uber. It always brings me joy in Highlander to see Ubers used, because a lot of teams, as I said, do prefer the Kurtzkrieg, and I think use it maybe too much. So, nice switch by them. It did work out quite well for them, and now they're going to be behind on Uber. You're going to have the crits coming in soon for Prawn, but we'll see how they deal with that because they don't have anything to actually deflect it.
So far, they're dealing with it by losing their soldier. I think maybe he wanted to jump in and try to stop us. Oh, Earl comes in and takes down that demo man. I think it was Earl anyway. Yeah, it was. But the Heavy still got some good damage in with the crits. Maybe not enough, though.
Yeah, he didn't really get that many players. The medic is still up. They have the Uber charge now. It popped pretty early because they actually kind of need to at this point to defend the point or capture it, or I can't
tell. Yeah, they got to recapture now, and they have to hold for another 46 seconds. JJK got a nice kill on the Heavy that's going to enable his team to push on. Can they cap it? They've got a lot of players sitting on it right now, but a scout trying to stop that. Zidium got covered in the PP and then finished off with a rocket. So now 40 seconds or so left before the Syndicate can win this round, but remember, blue team just has to cap it, and they win.
Yes, they are going to get Kurtzkrieg in time. I don't know that they are going to actually get the Uber in time, though. Somebody really needs to be building at this point, trying to charge that Uber as fast as possible, seeing if they can actually get it. Prawn is probably going to wait for it to do their push. They really need to bank on this is going to work.
Yeah, there was a good attempt at a jump in to kill the medic by that soldier, but a little bit too late. The crits is in now, and they take down Jordy, so the medic is gone. That's going to be no Uber to stop this point capture, and Blue is going to capture it, bringing it to 2-1 in favor of Team Prawn.
Good game there once again. Right into the next one, no halftime quite yet. No team switch, thank God, because I will forget who is who.
Oh, they're going to do that after halftime, you know.
Yes, yes, I know. It depresses me.
The problems of having a HUD that doesn't work.
Yes, I probably should have looked into that a little bit more before we got started. Are going in once again. I think Red Team is still using the regular Uber. They've got that going quite well. That was Jackal on the medic, was unable to actually get him, but caused a lot of distraction there, and I think they're actually losing out because of it.
It's kind of a no man's land on the point right now. Nobody's able to get onto it, because as soon as they do, well, I was going to say as soon as they do, they take a lot of damage, but it looks like Red Team finally managed to get the better of their opponents with their heavy down for Blue, so the Syndicate is going to capture the round first, and that's actually a first this game. I don't think they've captured it first for any of the rounds.
I will take your word on that. A big backstab goes down, takes down the medic while they were in the middle of their crits creek. Really nice by him.
And Haku's just going to wander around looking for that spy. The spy does manage to take down Sexy Shane, and so there's not going to be any more engineer buildings for a while. But Haku seems to have found the spy, Jackal, who is using that spy sickle, so was invulnerable to fire for a little while there.
Yes, my health indicator is also cut off, so it looked like the Heavy had 2 health, and he pulled out his Gru, and I almost just, like, screamed at my screen, like, no, we're gonna... fortunately enough, my HUD is messed up, so he survived.
I know that feeling. Every time I see somebody walk over a sticky trap in these games, I'm just like,
in slow motion, you see it happen. But
they reach out towards the screen and just go, no!
I wish it was more like a movie where they could jump in slow motion away from it, but it's more like slow motion Gibbs everywhere. Crits Krieg popped to kill a spy. I think it was just sort of a panic. Oh my god, no, please don't stab me. But it looks like it's actually going to work out really well over here, taking down the Heavy, making everyone scatter. They just ran wherever they could to get away from it.
Yeah, Malus did flash to Tapes at the very end there, but Tapes didn't quite time that shot right. I don't think they realized he was going to get it anyway, so didn't actually get a crit sticky off. Kind of wishes he had, but I don't think it would have done any damage with it anyway. And now he's just going to start setting up those normal sticky traps again, as the blue team, Team Prawn, is in control of the point and could be in control for a while.
Yeah, it looks like they have a really solid hold on it. They're going to need to wait until the Syndicate gets their crits krieg or whatever it is that they're running now. Yes, they are running crits at the moment. Probably going to wait to do their push until they have that. They are at 96% at the moment, so any second now. Any second now. Oh no, crits popped by the blue team. Everyone has crits.
Ooh, snap!
Crits. But it did not go well for them at all. They walked into their death. Welcome to die.
Pretty much, yeah. The Pyro and Engineer over here doing some really good damage to the blue team, finishing off both Pyro and Demo. And now the Syndicate can run up to the point, recapture it, and they've killed Malin, so they're going to have a bit of a crits advantage.
Yeah, it's definitely looking good once again for the Syndicate. This is very back and forth. This map usually does go that way, where one team wins, the next team says, no, you didn't. They come back, and they win.
Oh, Jackal's dead. Okay, I was going to watch Jackal. He already died. I got to find Stabby. Stabby's dead, too. Oh, I'm terrible.
Do we need, like, a wake?
Maybe. Anyway, the Syndicate still controlling the point. They may not control it for long. It seems like it was it's getting somebody on it to capture, and the medic was calling for help here. Did he get away from that? It looks like he didn't. Jordy is down.
Malin and the Heavy are pushed pretty far up on the tunnel side of the map. Oh, and then the Heavy just walks into... he crits him when he has the Gru out. That was very, very sloppy, but he still dies somehow. Thankfully, that was a mess right there, but it worked out.
Malin's got away. Oh, didn't get away. He had 8 health, and then Stabby came in to finish him off, saw that opportunity, and just took it. So he evened out the Ubers very nicely. In fact, gave his team an advantage just by sacrificing himself there.
Watching Earl's sweatshirt right now. He is moving in, clearing some stickies off of the point, make sure his team can get up there. And he's playing a very passive scout right now, not really trying to go back and kill anyone. He's sort of staying with his team as much as he can until he runs onto some stickies. No!
No, don't do that, Earl! But that is actually a very common thing that you'll see, especially in Highlander, where so many classes are just capable of practically one-shotting or killing the scout before he can respond. You gotta wait for those opportunities to open up.
Yeah, you definitely have room to be a big part of the team here on Viaduct as scout, but you need to be very, very careful about how you do that, because anywhere you walk could be your doom. Kritzkrieg is popped by Geordi, and he jumps in front of a heavy. It didn't work out very well for them. The medic for Blue is, he's got milk all over him. He is dripping wet. And then Spy happened.
Stabby, shut down that crit. He is getting chased down by a sniper now with the PP out, and oh, a jump stab on the stairs. Oh man, Stabby going insane.
Meanwhile, Jackal's doing work on the other side as well. Gets a backstab on the soldier and a dispenser pick. Time to move in, guys.
Yeah, those dispenser picks, all important. If you take out their dispenser, of course, I mean, then where are they going to have their dispenser, I guess, right? And there you go.
All joking aside, dispensers actually really, really helpful on this map for the Heavy and the Pyro. So they are using all of their ammo nonstop. Demo as well, it's just constant spamming, so very helpful here.
Medic down for the red team once again, but half the blue team is dead, and they only have 10 seconds left on the point, but that gives red team some good time to try and get the capture and tie this game up. Right now it is, of course, 2-1 in favor of Team Prom. And
Geordi is actually down at the moment. Malin goes down too, so never mind what I was about to say. Out the window, they are now even again.
Yeah, I was going to say, Malin was coming in there with a crits advantage, and just didn't work out for him. Jackal gets taken down, going for the sniper, and so the sniper is still alive. Sky Messiah might know where he is, but he's not aiming in that direction. The rest of his team is just pushing straight onto the point.
Yep.
Now, oh, Skype sees the medic, can't quite get that shot off. Geordi only has, yeah, there you go, he does finish off Geordi with a body shot, not even scoped in, and look at how close this round is, 7 seconds to six at one point.
Yes, just two people were up on the Syndicate. Stabby just uncloaks on the point, but the whole team is there. Not gonna work out. That is 3-1 in favor of Prawn.
And that is halftime. We'll be right back after these messages from our sponsors. Oh, man, Star, I just love our sponsors, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Thank you, guys. We need that money.
That might be true. Anyway, the round has started and both scouts died. So Earl and Zidium both gone. And by the way, it seems like the teams did not swap colors.
I thank them for that, though they are supposed to. I thank them personally.
Oh, Geordi is playing a dangerous game there. Jackal got in behind him and was going for stab, but Geordi just kind of kept his cool, and now he's got the crits.
It popped on Prawn. I didn't get to see what Geordi had because he immediately exploded into many pieces. Big stab going on there as well, and both teams are just... Where did they go?
It's 2v2 right now with a Spy decloaking and trying to go for this, but Stabby is going to have to retreat. The snipers are going at each other now, but there is a scout to play spoiler on this, and Zidium does take down JJK. Finishes off Stabby 2.
Prawn wins the 2v2. They have the point because of it. Good to the sniper and scout.
Yeah, Bravo was sneaking in trying to kill that sniper, but he didn't manage to finish him off, and now is going to have to back up. He does help capture the point, and look at that. Less than 20 seconds were put on that timer for Team Prawn. They're going to need to hold on to these points a little bit longer.
Yeah, both teams are, in fact, using the critical Krieg. Geordi has it already, so we're probably going to be seeing that pretty soon, and there it is already, once again.
Oh, snap! Pig going for the shots, but this it's like everybody's just kind of avoiding them right now.
Hot potato. If you get your critical Krieg up, you have to use it. Spy went for the stab on the blue medic, but missed it. A little bit unfortunate there. It seems like it's become a common trend of this match that the Kritzkrieg medic is getting backstabbed.
Or his target. Actually, it looked like the blue demo man, Tapes, did get stabbed. So, one way or the other, that Kritz is going to get shut down.
Malin actually goes down to a stab by Stabby Stabby. Stab a lot of times in that sentence. I'm proud of that one.
I think you can do more. I think you can say more stabs.
I'll prepare for it, and maybe we'll see that later.
The stab of Stabby Stabby, his stabbing skill managed to cause a stab on his opponent, who did in fact die to that stab.
That's a run-on, and you should be ashamed. I'm reporting you to
AOL. There's nothing wrong with redundancy!
Anyway, we have a match going on. Jordy is popping Critical Krieg on the red demo man. He's doing work with that, getting a one kill, doing work, if that's what doing work is.
He did get a kill. He got a kill after Critical Krieg was over on that Pyro as well. The Pyro was trying to air blast him into the corner, but he managed to time his grenade so that Pyro could not air blast it. Blue that's still has the point now.
Prawn actually played that Critical Krieg quite well, where their team just seemed to split apart, and he didn't know who to go after, and got sort of caught up trying to kill the heavy.
KTB is in here trying to go for the kill on the teleporter. He's actually taking the Crits Krieg and cannot hit anybody with it. Oh man, so there's still a teleporter up in there. I don't think anybody's going to be taking any game signs soon, or at least they shouldn't, because that would be ridiculous.
Ooh, was that a headshot on Malin?
It indeed yes, was. JJK indeed. Took him down. Jordy, looks like he actually did take the teleporter and is now healing his own spy, which is a little dangerous. Not going to have any
protection
there.
Pocket spy was actually, the spy did help save him a little bit from that pyro, at least enough time to delay him.
Yeah, well, there you go. It's going to be Jordy with a bit of a crits advantage. He's got to be careful about pushing too far forwards, because if he does that, he could get sniped, he could get taken down by any number of players out there. It's a very small map for that to happen.
Jackal is invisible coming out of the house, immediately spotted by the scout. They kind of knew he was there already. Unfortunate there. Pretty hard to get things done as spy, which I'm surprised to see. A lot of spy work was done on this map. Actually, I take that back. Earlier I said spy was awesome on this map. That is also true.
Okay. Anyway, Jordy is going to pop the crits. He's popping it on the heavy, and I think they've realized this is happening already. He's going to finish it off with the... Oh, there you go, with Pig O' Death, who does take down Fade. But Jordy gets stabbed by Jackal, and now Blue Team is going on a rampage.
Yep, Point is still controlled by the Syndicate. Looks like they're going to be holding on to that for quite a while now, though they do have a medic down. Malin goes down as well to a body shot, so they're going to need to wait for that. Or just push right now. There are a lot of losses on the Syndicate. They could probably get that Cougar. Walking his sentry up just gets taken down by the sniper as well.
Yeah, it's actually really nice for JJK. He's got a dispenser right there. He can just sit next to it and get himself healed up. The medic does overheal him so that he won't get taken down very, very quickly. But never mind. Soldier jumped right on top of him.
As soon as you say that, the person is going to die. So you should just keep your mouth shut.
I know.
It's your fault.
It is. It's true. They played this game in the past. We are casting it from a demo, but it's
you
still
have
true.
That power.
Well, I think they have that power. They're actually they are capable of seeing into the future. I just want to make my call as soon as possible.
Popping Crits Krieg as soon as they get it. At the very second it hit like 99, I saw it starting to go down because it was used, and then counter popped by Malin on the heavy, looking for someone to kill. If he just had turned around and aimed at them, I think he could have got maybe two kills there, but they opted to run away, and it looks like altogether Prawn is completely wiped.
Wow.
Not a single person surviving that. Not too often you see that in Highlander.
Yeah, the Syndicate getting really far forward now. They really want to win this, and a nice kill on Skype Messiah. Now Pig O' Death is, he knows his limits. He took down one kill over there. He doesn't want to get flanked, so he ran back and is just going to stay on the point. Play farther back.
Bigger things going on. 10 seconds left that they need to control the point, and they almost have Crits Krieg. It looks like they're probably going to be able to pull this off. There is the crits popped, throwing crit stickies everywhere to defend it, and they've got it.
So the Syndicate brings it to 2-3. They still have to win 2 rounds to secure a victory. Their opponents only have to win 1.
Yes.
Getting a little quiet here. But it's not an awkward silence, it's a good silence.
I know, I was thinking about the score. I was doing mathematician algebra in my head to figure out the score there.
So that's what I get paid to do, is that kind of math, you know? What's
yes,
2 plus 1?
It's a good thing I have you here, the accountant, keeping track of them numbers. I can't do it.
Cougar with his white cowboy hat, looking pretty swanky, I gotta say, for a Texan. Not too bad. Those kind of hats can actually be pretty expensive, I gotta say. They're you get a Stetson? Those things
God,
can be
no,
in the 3-digit range, man. These can be expensive hats. Fade taking down the opponent.
The medic that died, they've got hats on right now.
Oh, yeah.
The blue heavy is looking mighty swag.
He is. He really is. That's a nice hat on him, too. But yes, it's going to be Jordy with a crits advantage. Where are they right now, though? Are they in a position to push with this? And looks like they will keep their advantage as they walk out this left-hand side, immediately popping the crits.
They've been at 100% for more. I'm surprised, and he goes down. He probably should have, but that's why they've been doing it. Big stab going down by Stabby Stabby on Flak, not able to get the medic though because he was sort of backed up into a corner, though still looking very vulnerable. Jackal also dying in a huge explosion on the other side of the map.
Somehow Stabby just managed to dodge temporarily, pulling out the ambassador, but no, gets taken down by that sniper finally. Although one thing he was doing there was distracting the enemy team for a little while.
Malin pops crits on the demo man. A lot of opportunity to kill people right here, and there is one big explosion taking down two players at once. Demo man from Red is on top of the roof though of that building. Nobody saw him and helps clean up afterwards once the crits has faded. It looks like the Syndicate's actually gonna have a really good opportunity to get the point back right here if they can just get a couple of the kills. No, not going in their favor.
No, look at that. Yeah, there are only four players up right now. Pig of Death is one of them, and he's a extremely good demo man. But he can't take on the enemy team by himself. And there you go, Zidium runs up and finishes him off with that scattergun.
Heavy for the Syndicate also gets backstabbed to add insult to injury. They aren't doing too well on this push. They haven't actually touched the point yet. They're still at 3 minutes. 1 minute for Prawn at the moment. They're looking really strong in this match.
Yeah, I gotta say, Prawn could take it right here unless the Syndicate can do something crazy, because it's only a minute left to go before Proprietary 9 take the match.
Yes, it's 1 minute left to go, and their medic is down, so they're not even charging at the moment. It's a good thing he has the Vitasaw, so they are going to be able to get one last Crits Creek attempt in here, assuming that they don't get the control point back.
Yeah, Malent and his demo man there, Tapes, were doing some crazy work. Malent ends up healing Stabby for a second and is going to have to pull out the needles to try and get away from him. But he will get away. Got the Crits Creek ready on his heavy. Now he's got to remember that Spy is behind him and could be sneaking in any time, but he's not even looking right now. And he's just making sure his heavy does some damage. There you go, they do turn around now to watch the Spy. Looks like Prawn might have this.
Yeah, they've got a very, very good hold here. Actually, Syndicate is coming in at the moment on the point. But they are going to have a difficult time holding this for an entire 3 minutes when Prawn only needs to hold it for that 9. Proprietary 9, what?
Oh, I like that. I like how appropriate their name is today, as the Proprietary 9 seconds is all they need to win the game.
And it looks like they're going to probably do that. They're making a push over here. On the left side, we have the Heavy getting taken down by a Scout. No. Not looking as good as I thought they were, but they actually are on the point, even though they don't have the crits charged or anything quite yet. Syndicate does have their crit streak ready, but I don't see where their medic exactly is. Ooh, medic is busy getting backstabbed. That is where he was.
Tape's doing some big damage right now, and actually the soldier for the blue team there who got that jump in, he didn't kill Jordy himself, did not kill the medic, but he caused the entire red team to turn around and look at him, and that gave blue a lot of opportunity to jump in and get some kills. Now, Malent does get taken down by JJK, but the point is going to be captured here by the blue team, so 8 seconds left. The Syndicate has to jump in and cap it right now or they lose.
Everyone is jumping, they're all making attempts at the point, just sort of clustering on top of it, but doesn't work out. It even looked like the engineer was standing on it, but no, he apparently wasn't. And that is a good game, a very good game, by the Syndicate and Prawn.
Yeah, I'm just going to read down these scores real quick, or I'll let people do that if they want to. They can hit the pause button right here if they want to see. But yeah, a really good game. It was 4-2 in the end for Proprietary 9, and thank you for joining me, Star. I want to give a shout out to your channel, man.
Go watch it.
Yes.
That's all the shout out I need.
Do it. Watch mine too. And we're good to go.
We're done.
That's it. Get out of here.